Okay, good morning, guys. Welcome to the another floriculture session. Today we will deal on the history of gardening in India. Okay. I hope my voice is clear and the screen is visible now for everybody.
Yes, sir, voice is clear.
Yeah. Then we will continue the class now. Coming to the history of gardening is as old as our civilization. There's a saying, the age of rose is older than the man. This is an important objective type questions. These are all in this aspect with respect to history of gardening landscape in India, the sayings, the meaning, the similarity, what they say, the correlation between the man and the garden, gods, the plants. These are all very important with respect to objective type questions for the JRF and SRF. So here, every aspect is important. You listen like a story. You capture the points as a bulletins in your mind. These are all very important for the objective type questions. Here, one of the famous question in JRF or any competitive exams. The age of rose is older than the man. Which among the following statement is the given statement? They will give some 2 to 3 statements. They will ask the questions or the objective, like give a reason and assertion type or the objective. Both the A and B same. Both the A and B are false. Like that, they will going to answer. They will going to give the choices. So remember, the age of rose is older than the man. This is also very important point. Before the man arrives to earth or for this universe, the rose was existed. Like that, you remember. Then the first evidence of an ornamental plant was found in Mohenjo-daro civilization. First was Pipal, Ficus religiosa, comes from the seal of Mohenjo-daro. This is under third BC. Then weeping willow, Salix babylonica. This is from Harappa and Mohenjo-daro. These civilization were important. These are all the first evidence for the ornamental plants. Then after that, the Aryans will come. They were the great lovers of trees and flowers. The Aryans period was 1600 BC. The lotus has mentioned frequently in the Sanskrit sculptures as in the Vedic times. The Aryaratha are the Vedic mentions of people, you know, Ficus religiosa. These are frequently mentioned in the Vedic times due to its medicinal or for this aesthetic purpose. Then in Ramayana, it has been narrated that the places have a very nice gardens with the numerous flowers and the shady groves. The lakes are full of lotus. These lakes are full of lotus. Then Ashokavana, where the Sita was held in captivity by Ravana. This Ashokavana is important. Ashokavana means mostly composed of Saraka Ashoka or Saraka Indica plants. Then in Mahabharata, Sabha Parva, this epic deals with the description of pleasure gardens, park, lakes, in and around the Indraprastha. This is the capital city of whose capital city? Indraprastha, the present Delhi. In Ramayana, this is the capital city at that time. Pandavas, Kauravas, this was the capital. Sabha Parva, you remember the Sabha Parva is the epic under the Mahabharata. It will deals with the pleasure gardens, park and lakes. This is important. And sometimes the Indraprastha, this is also important. This is the capital city of, you should remember this one. This is a general question. Okay. Then this epic will describe the many, the following trees and creepers. Ficus benjamina, Ficus religiosa, Araka Sita, Saraka Ashoka, Saraka Indica, Michaelia Champaka, Terminalia Arjuna. These are the important species which are described in the Sabha Parva. Hence, this topic is important, Sabha Parva. Further, the lotus is a popular flower regarded by Hindus and Buddhists as a symbol of purity. This one is important. This is free from any mud sticking. If it is grown in the dirty ponds also, it is free from mud. No dirt can stick onto it. Hence, this is compared for the purity. When you are free, you go and search in the Google, what do you mean by the lotus effect? The lotus petals, the arrangement or the shininess on the leaf is in such a way that no dirt particle or any mud will not stick on the leaves of lotus. This effect is also already exploited in many other aspects in our daily life. If you are in free time, you search that lotus effect. Then further in Mahabharata, it is mentioned that Bhima brought a lotus which has a thousands of petals glowing like a sun with a sweet heavenly fragrance for the Sita. You remember in Mahabharata, Bhima brought the lotus which contains thousands of petals for Sita. Then Aryas developed some wishful thinking in the form of Kalparuksha, means wish granting tree. Kalpalata, which is a similar creeper. You remember Kalparuksha means wish granting tree. Kalpalata means wish granting creeper. Which is Kalparuksha commonly called?
Coconut, sir.
Which one?
Coconut.
Yeah, Kalparuksha is coconut. Many other palms also regarded as Kalparuksha. Like this palm rose is also termed as Kalparuksha sometimes. Those peculiar names you have to be remember. Then the faith goes that anybody standing under these creepers or the trees, this will wish anything from the jewelry or the beautiful clothes, gold, food, like that. So it is called wish granting tree. Then one sculpture depicting such a tree dating back to the 3rd century, now preserved in the Kolkata Museum, identified as banyan tree. This is also Kalparuksha. In the ornamental, this is a Kalparuksha. You need to remember this one. 3rd century specimen preserved at Kolkata Museum. Banyan tree. Then the legendary stories. Once Vishnu was taking the bath in a lake on the earth when a lotus bloomed and from within came out Pita Brahma. When Vishnu was taking the bath from the lake, Brahma came. And who claimed that lotus was the prettiest flower one had ever seen. Brahma told, lotus was the prettiest flower. This statement you need to remember. Then, although Vishnu agreed for that, further, he took to Vaikuntha and showed him a rose bloom, full of sweet fragrance. Then Brahma changed his views and accepted rose as the prettiest bloom in the universe. This is important one with respect to assertion and reasoning type questions. Here initially Brahma told lotus was the prettiest flower. After with the discussion of Vishnu, he changed his views and accepted rose is the prettiest bloom in the universe. These two statements are important. Then association of different trees with the life of Lord Buddha. This is also very important, well-known concept. Then Buddha was born in the 600 BC under the Ashoka tree, Saraka Indica. Then other trees associated with the birth of Buddha are salt tree, Shorya Robusta. Then Palaksha, Vitia Monosporma. These are all associated with the birth of Buddha. Mainly this Ashoka tree. This was confirmed with the great Chinese traveler Yuan Shan, who came to India during 630 AD. Then Buddha attained the enlightenment under the peepal tree. Then spread his teachings under the shade of banyan trees and mango tree. And he died under Sal's tree, Sal's brew, Shorya Robusta. Born under Ashoka or Sal. These are all the important trees associated with the birth of Buddha. Then attained the enlightenment under peepal tree. Then teaching was started under banyan and mango trees and died under Sal groves. This is important type, important objective points. Okay. Further, the great emperor Ashoka adopted the arboriculture. Arboriculture means cultivation of trees in his state policy. Hence, Ashoka is now regarded as father of arboriculture. You remember this one? Arboriculture means cultivation of tree species or forest species. Father is Emperor Ashoka. They may ask who was the first person who adopted the arboriculture in his state policy, or they may ask the father of arboriculture, like that they will ask. Then he encouraged the planting of avenue plants, Bodhi Ruksha, Ficus religiosa. You remember the common name, Bodhi tree or Bodhi Ruksha, Ficus religiosa. Then people was regarded as a sacred tree even before the birth of Buddha. People was regarded as sacred tree even before the birth of Buddha. This is also important statement. Even before the Buddha. Then Atharvana Veda says, the gods of third heaven sit under the tree of Ashwata. What do you mean by Ashwata? Ashwata tree. Ficus Benjamina. Right? Ashwata Ruksha. Then in the works of Kalidasa, he mentioned regarding the several flowering trees. You remember Kalidasa mentioned several flowering trees in his poems, like Ashoka tree, Kadamba, Arjuna, Bhutia, Parijata, Bahuya. This Bahuya is regarded as a, this correlated with the Saraswati. You need to remember the trees associated with the gods. You need to remember Arjuna with respect to Krishna. Then Bhutia, Shiva, Parijata, then we'll discuss it later. Then with respect to creeper, Madhavilata, Hiptage, this Hiptage species, Madhavilata, is occupied as a prominent place in the Shakuntala. This is an act, this is an, what do you call, story book written by Shakuntala. Who wrote this? Kalidasa. Then Vatsayana, this is also very important. Vatsayana wrote in his book Kama Sutra, he narrates four kinds of garden. This is also very important. Vatsayana wrote Kama Sutra. This is the book. In this book, Pramodhyana, this garden is for the enjoyment of royal couples. Then Udyana. Udyana means where the kings place the chairs, enjoy the dance of dancers. Then Vrikshavatika. Here, the garden where the high placed persons in the king's court enjoy the life with their company. This is called Vrikshavatika. For the Nandanavana. Nandanavana is dedicated for the Lord Krishna. You need to remember the which are all the four kinds of garden narrated in the Kama Sutra by Vatsayana. Pramodhyana for the royal couples. Udyana for the enjoyment. For sitting and seeing of dances. Then Vrikshavatika means this for the high placed persons like king's associates. Then for the Nandanavana, dedicated for the Lord Krishna. Then Vatsayana also describes the duties of a virtuous wife. Means he describes how should be a wife. A loyal and affectionate wife should lay out a garden in and around his house. The garden should be planted with a fragrant rose like jasmine, tuber montana, coronaria, then china rose. These are all the plants should be there in the garden of her house. This is the duty of a virtuous wife. What's that? Described like this. A royal and affectionate wife should lay out a garden in and around his wife. This statement was given by Vatsyayana. And he also advised that a good housewife should contract arbors and seeds in the garden. Arbors means trees. She should plant many trees, forest species.
Virtuous wife meaning
what?
It's meaning of virtuous wife.
Virtuous means very dedicated, affectionate, loyal, like that. Okay. She should plant trees and she should lay out the seeds, garden seeds. Then further, the Mughal era comes in India. Here the Mughals have contributed more with respect to development of gardens in India. One of the prominent was Firoz Shah Tughlaq, who developed about 1200 gardens in and around the Delhi. Hence, we have also named a cricket stadium in Delhi called Firoz Shah Tughlaq. What do you call that stadium? Firoz Shah Kotla in Delhi. This is also an important one. Firoz Shah Kotla stadium located at Delhi. The name of Firoz Shah Tughlaq for his contribution of gardens in India. Further, the Babur lay out the foundation for the Mughal Empire in India. Firoz Shah was the first king who established the many gardens in Delhi. He was the first Mughal ruler laid out for the gardens. Further, Babur. And he was also a great lover of flowers and gardens. Immediately after his first victory at Panipat, he laid out a garden there. Babur laid out a garden at Panipat. This is the first garden by Babur. Further, at Agra, the garden at Agra, known as Rami Bagh. Then, after the Babur, Akbar came. Akbar built a new capital, Fatehpur Sikri. Then he established a gardens at Kashmir. Akbar was the first king who developed the gardens at Kashmir, Nasim Bagh, close to Dal Lake. Nasim Bagh was a garden laid out by Akbar at the Kashmir. Then tomb garden of Akbar was built at Sikandra. Then Jahangir and Noor Jahan, these two important rulers also with respect to gardening. Jahangir also built a garden at Shalimar Garden, Chabul Garden, Veer Nagin, Kashmir. These are all the three gardens built by Jahangir. Then what is the contribution of his wife Noor Jahan? She discovered the rosotto, means when she was taking the bath in the hot water sprinkled with the rose petals, suddenly she pointed out the rose oil emitting from the rose petals. Further, she developed the technique of rose water extraction. This was the main contribution of Noor Jahan. Then further, Shah Jahan also created many beautiful gardens. Red Fort in Delhi by Shah Jahan. Then Taj Mahal in Agra in the memory of his beloved queen Mumtaz. Then Chashmi Shahi at Kashmir. This is also important one. Then Shalimar Garden at Lahore. Now it is in Punjab. Shalimar Garden at Lahore. Here also, Jahangir built the Shalimar Garden. Here, he built that Shalimar Garden at in India. Here, Shah Jahan built the Shalimar Garden in Lahore, Pakistan. Then Shesha Suri constructed the Grand Trunk Road. This is very important one. Grand Trunk Road is associated with the Shesha Suri. He planted the many avenue trees along the both side of road. Then next comes to Nawabs of Oudh. These are all the different rulers. This completes the Mughal Empire. Then Ouds will come. Nawabs. Sikandar Bagh by Nawab Waji Ali Shah. This is also an important one because later on this Sikandar Bagh converted into National Botanical Research Institute. Now it is located in Lucknow, UP. Okay. For the Rajputs in India came. They also built many several gardens. Amber Fort near Jaipur, built by Man Singh. He started the Amber Fort near Jaipur, completed by Jai Singh II. This beautiful garden laid out in the three terraces and one lake. I think you have been visited during your All India tour, Amber Fort. It is in Jaipur, near the Jaipur, built by Man Singh. It has the three terraces, means initially at the arrival, it has one lake followed by the bridge. Then we will follow the upper section of one terrace. Further, it continues the second and third terraces. There is a mall, there is a palace also, Mahal. Then Mandor Garden near Jodhpur by Raja Abhay Singh. You need to remember this one. Mandor Garden by Raja Abhay Singh. Amber Fort by Man Singh. Further, the Garden Palace Deeg was founded by Suraj Mahal with many fountains, water courses, and other features. The water bodies are the main features of Mughal Gardens. Then after this will come to this will complete the Rajputs. Further, the British came to India. They have a whole different pattern of gardening in India. Initially, the Mughals were developed symmetrical pattern gardens. Further, the English changed the styles into informal type, symmetrical or formal type gardens. Opposite one is informal or asymmetrical pattern gardens. Then until Indian gardens have only the scented trees, rose, climbers, bulbs, but no flowering annuals. The main contribution of Britishers were they introduced many flowering annuals to Indian gardens, mainly from the Mauritius country. You need to remember this one, their contribution. Then English brought the beautiful annuals, biennials such as phlox, carnation, verbena, dahlia, larkspur. These are all the beautiful annuals and biennials. They were imported from the Mauritius. This was the main contribution of British East India Company with respect to gardening in India. Then, before arrival of English to India, knew how to make the garlands and bouquets. The idea of flower arrangement for the interior decoration was taught by Britishers. The flower arrangement, interior decoration was taught by Britishers. Then the greatest contribution by Britishers was establishment of botanical gardens, starting from the one established near the Kolkata, which was that we were earlier discussed, the Agri Horticultural Society of India, located at Kolkata. And further, many botanical gardens also located in Kolkata. They were established by Britishers. The present day garden styles in India, more or less with the pattern of British style only. This was the main contribution of Britishers. Then further, we will discuss some of the important key points from my short notes. This is like a rewinding of this syllabus. Okay. Is this boring?
No, sir.
Yeah. I'll just discuss out the some of the points. With respect to civilization, Harappa civilization, you need to remember the Salix. Salix and weeping willow. These were the first description. Then in earlier days, what we wrote like Veda, Upanishads, we used to use the leaves of Betulia species. These are all the tree species found in the Himalaya. The bark has been chopped into a fine leaf, Betula, B-E-T-U-L-A. Then further, Palmyra leaves also used for the writing. Then Aryavarta means land of lotus or sunshine. Then in Vedas, people and lotus tree symbolize the purity. You need to remember this one. Indraprastha, it's a land of garden, city of garden. This will comes in objective or reasoning assertion type or match the following, true or false. So you need to remember the statements also and key points also. That's why I'm repeating. Then Sabha Parva, this is the epic in Mahabharata, which deals with the ornamental plants. Bhima brought the 1,000-petal lotus, which symbolized the youth and rival beauty. You need to remember this one. Lotus for purity, lotus for youth and beauty. Banyan tree, Kalparuksha, wish-granting tree. Vishnu told, rose is the prettiest flower in the world. Brahma told, lotus is the prettiest flower in world. Then Kadamba for Krishna. Samal means Bombax malabarica or Bombax sibba. You heard wild silk cotton tree. This is the Bombax. This is for Shiva. Samal tree. Kadamba for Krishna. Bohania for Saraswati. Amaranthus for goddess Kali. You need to remember this one. If possible, you take a note, short note. And with respect to Buddha, he born under Ashoka or Ashoka Samal tree. Then enlightenment under people tree. Teaching under mango and banyan tree. Died under salt tree. Then further, the Ashoka son, Mahendra Sangamitra, he sent to Sri Lanka for propagating the Buddhist and arboriculture system. He planted many banyan trees in Aurangapur in Sri Lanka. You need to remember his son Mahendra Sangamitra planted many banyan trees in Sri Lanka. Buddha Sattvas means birth of Buddha. This is a epic. Buddha Sattva. This is a book deals with the birth of Buddha. Albarje Lavak means, what is the vernacular name? Human's tongue tree. Which era is called as golden era of Hindus? Gupta's period. Gupta's period is the golden era of Hindus. Then father, Nandaravana father, Lord Krishna. It's associated with the Lord Krishna. Here, the Buddha visited the Nandaravana. You need to remember this one. Which among the following garden visited the Buddha? They will ask, definitely, this is a question. Nandanavana, this is associated with the Lord Krishna and Buddha also visited during his teaching. Then further, with respect to Vatsayana, Pramodhyana, Udhyana, Vrikshavatika, Nandanavana. These are the four gardens. Then what is the contribution of Christians or Christianity towards the gardening in India? Nothing. With respect to Mughals, they built thousands of gardens in Delhi. First contributor, Firoz Shah. Firoz Shah Kotla Stadium in Delhi. First ruler, Firoz Shah. then Babur. After that, Humayun, Akbar, Jahangir, Shah Jahan, Aurangzeb. Then Aurangabad. Aurangabad built by Babur. Humayun built the Grand Trunk Road. Then father of arboriculture, you know Ashoka. Then Nasim Bagh by Akbar. Jahangir built Achaful Garden, Veerna Garden. Noor Jahan, Rose Otto. Shah Jahan, Red Fort at Delhi, Red Fort at Agra, Taj Mahal. Then Nawabs also very important. Nawabs of UP built, what do you call, Sikandar Bagh, National Botanical Research Institute. Okay, forget it at Lucknow. This is the very important and pakka question. Nawab Waji Ali Shah of Audh, Uttar Pradesh, built the Sikandar Bagh. Now we're regarded as National Botanical Research Institute, located at Lucknow. Then Rajput's also important one. Amber Fort at Jaipur by Man Singh. Then Patiala Garden by Bhupendra Singh. Fruit Garden at Chai, Himachal Pradesh by Bhupendra Singh and Yadavir Singh. Then with respect to East India Company. In South India, the Lal Bagh Garden laid out by Hyder Ali. This is important. Hyder Ali built the Lal Bagh Garden. This is initially formal type garden. Further, the Britishers converted into informal type of garden. Now it is informal type of garden. You need to remember Lal Bagh Garden built by Hyder Ali. Father, his son Tipu Sultan developed it. Hyder Ali and Tipu Sultan were associated with the Lal Bagh Garden. Then Britishers introduced many exotic annuals. Then they created the Agri-Hearty Society and many botanical gardens. Then further, the Britishers, they exported or they took away our rhododendron species from India to Europe. Rhododendron, primula, many orchid species from India to Europe. Rhododendron sanctuary located at Sikkim. You need to remember this one. This is an important concept. Rhododendron sanctuary. We have a sanctuary and rhododendrons.
Sir, rhodo?
Rhododendron. Rhododendra. Rhododendrons. You Google, you will find the images. These are all the forest species now exploited for the ornamental and gardening also. In Sikkim, these are all wildly grown. For the conservation of rhododendrons, for the conservation of these rhododendrons, Indian government has established a sanctuary in Sikkim. This is also very objective type questions. Then further, this will come to the East India Company. After that, post-independence era, after we got the independence, the garden development was little bit slow or nothing much related with respect to gardening or landscaping. We were shortage with the food, more poverty, crisis will be there. After the post-independence era, no much gardens were developed during this time. But nowadays, we have a huge scope in gardening, ornamental, landscaping, like that. Further, we will discuss with the important gardens of India with respect to like location type, Karnataka, Delhi, UP, Lahore, which are all the important gardens located in the, which are all the areas. You can take a printout of India map, or you can draw a India map in a rough sheet, so you can locate the all the gardens in one map. Like if you consider Jammu and Kashmir, firstly we will see according Jammu Kashmir gardens means you'll find the when the leaves falling during the winters and the yellow colored leaves will turn into brownish, which is that species, you know, which trees or which plant which shows the seasonal variability, you know that chenar tree, chenar, this is a tree which shows the color variation or the seasonality. Further, in Jammu Kashmir, mainly the Nasim Bagh, Shalimar Garden, Nishant Bagh, Chashmi Shahi, Veerna Garden, Achabal Garden, these are all located. Okay, you try to figure out in a map so that it will be easy to remember. Then, you know, Indira Gandhi Memorial Tulip Garden located at Kashmir. This is the biggest tulip garden in India. Then further in Lahore, Dilkush Garden by Jahangir. Then Shalimar Garden by Shah Jahan located at Lahore. It is in Pakistan. Then further in UP, Aram Bagh by Babur. Then Tom Garden by Aitab Ud Dilha. This is the Tom Garden located at UP. Then Red Fort at Agra, Taj Mahal at Agra. We have a Red Fort in Delhi also, in Agra also. Have you visited Red Fort in Agra? You only visit the Taj Mahal in Agra. It's also located in Agra only. Then further, NBRI is located at Lucknow. Secunderabad, you need to remember this. This one is very important. Then Botanical Garden at Sharapur. Now it is renamed as Horticulture Research Garden, Sharapur. Then further in Delhi, we have Rashtrapati Bhavan, that is Presidential House. In center of the garden, we have the Sunken Garden. This is a Mughal type garden. This was laid out by Lady Adach, and this was completed by Edwin Lutyens. This is also very important. Rashtrapati Bhavan. Rashtrapati Bhavan Garden is associated with Edwin Lutyens. And you remember this one, Edwin Lutyens. Then Buddha Jayanti Garden. You know, Buddha Jayanti Park at Delhi. This is in Japanese style. This is a flat garden. This was established in recently in the memory of 2500 anniversary of Buddha. Buddha Jayanti Park. This is located in Delhi. Then Roshnagar Garden in Delhi. Then Garden of Five Senses. This is also important. Garden of Five Senses located at Delhi. Then Red Fort by Shah Jahan. Then Humayun Tomb at Delhi. The best example for the Charbagh Garden is Humayun Tomb. Means four entrances will be there for this garden. Charbagh. Then in West Bengal, Royal Botanical Garden laid out by Sir George King at Darjeeling. You need to remember these points. Okay. These are all very important with respect to objective. Royal Botanical Garden by George King at Darjeeling. I think you're listening, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then what is the specialty of this garden? Means in this botanical garden, we have a Dawar red hood. It is a living fossil tree. Means this date back to many thousands year. Hence we call this is the living fossil tree, redwood tree, Dawar redwood tree. This is important one. And which is the living greenhouse. Means living greenhouse means it will give the shelter for thousands of other epiphytic plants on this tree. Pleca, P-L-E-C-C-A, pleca tree. This is regarded as living greenhouse. Then Indian Botanical Garden at Calcutta. This is an important one. Then Botanical Survey of India is located at Calcutta. You know which is the biggest leaf? Victoria Ridgea. You know Victoria? Victoria Ridgea. It's a lotus-like aquatic plant floats on the water surface. In Mahabharata also it becomes. The Karna will be floated on this leaf by Sita. You remember?
Sir, again repeat Victoria.
Victoria Ridgea. V-E-C-T-O-R-I-A. Victoria Ridgea. R-E-G-I-A. This is the biggest leaf. And further in West Bengal, we have the Agri Horticulture Society. Then in Tamil Nadu, we have the Sims Park. Sims, S-I-M-S. Sims Park at Konnur. You remember Sim series will come in Carnation. Then Government Botanical Garden at Ooty. Then Botanical Garden is located at Coimbatore. Now it is converted as Tamil Nadu Agricultural University, TNAU. Botanical Garden Coimbatore is termed as, now regarded as University, TNAU. Then Brand Park at Kodaikanal. Then in Chandigarh, you know, Rose Garden, largest rose garden in India. Then Rock Garden. Who was the architect for the Rock Garden? This is also very important. Chaud Saini, C-H-A-U-D. Saini, S-A-I-N-I. Then with respect to Gujarat Vadodara, Soyaji Park. What is the specialty of this park? We can observe the branching palms here. Soyaji Park, branching palms. Habenia tabaca. This is very important. Branching palm, Habenia tabaca. Then in Haryana, we have the Pinjor Garden. And further in Rajasthan, Mandor Garden by Raja Abhay Singh. Then Baradari Garden at Patiala. This is very important. Then Garden at Amritsar built by Ranjit Singh. Then in Karnataka, we have Brindavan Garden, biggest formal garden. You need to remember this one. Brindavan Garden, biggest formal garden. This is important one. Then Lal Bagh Botanical Garden, started by Haider Ali, completed by Tipu Sultan, his son. And British is converted into informal garden. Then what is the specialty of this garden, Lal Bagh Garden? We have a Araucaria cookie here. You know Araucaria cookie means monkey puzzle tree. Why it's called monkey puzzle tree? It will confuse us the monkeys also. This tree means this dried leaves also looks like greenish. Hence it's termed as monkey puzzle tree. Then in Lal Bagh we have the flower clock. And Rashtrapati Garden also we have the flower clock. This is the special feature in Lal Bagh and Rashtrapati Garden, flower clock. Paradise Garden of Iran, you know. Paradise Garden is located in Iran. Osaka Garden is located at Japan. The biggest tulip garden in India we have at
Indira Gandhi, Kashmir.
Yeah, at Kashmir. But in the world level, we have at Netherlands. In India, Indira Gandhi, tulip garden. In the world, at Netherlands. Then Garden of Edens, located at UK, England. This is also regarded as Genesis of Garden. Then you might have heard Hanging Garden are located at Hanging Gardens of Babylonia. You heard? This was the first sign of gardening in the civilization. We have the vertical gardening also there. Then in India we have Hanging Garden at Mumbai. Okay. Any doubts? Yes. Sir is asking whether the class is over. Yes, any doubts? Any points to add for this discussion? Any queries? Yes, please, Ankita.
No, sir.
Yeah, if it is the case, this was a pleasant class today. We'll discuss the next chapter in the next class. What we will discuss in the next chapter? We can discuss the styles of gardening, right? We can discuss styles of gardening.
Okay, sir.
Okay, then we will discuss the styles of gardening in the next chapter. Until then, take care, stay safe. Bye-bye.